Several types of ECG lead systems are available. Most commonly used are the standard limb leads and chest leads. Modified leads can be used for specific situations with certain advantages. ECG electrodes are the recording electrodes placed on the body and connected to the ECG machine. ECG lead is a combination of electrode from which the electrical potentials of the heart are recorded by the machine on paper or electronic memory. ECG uses four limb electrodes on each of the four limbs, of which the electrode on the right leg is considered electrically neutral, while the other three are active electrodes. Electrode combination for limb leads are as follows. Lead 1, left arm positive, right arm negative. Lead 2, right arm negative, left foot positive. Lead 3, left arm negative, left foot positive. Diagram illustrating the positive and negative poles of the three standard limb leads. Note that right arm is negative for leads 1 and 2. Left foot is positive for leads 2 and 3. Unipolar limb leads are derived using the limb lead electrode potentials. All the three limb leads are internally connected to a central terminal, Wilson's central terminal, using fixed value resistors. Usual limb lead recordings are called bipolar recordings, with one limb serving as positive electrode and another as negative electrode, as illustrated earlier. Unipolar recordings are obtained by taking the limb electrode as positive and central terminal as negative. Unipolar limb leads are called VR, VL and VF depending on whether the positive electrode is at the right arm, left arm or left leg. Voltages of these recordings can be augmented by disconnecting the connection to the corresponding limb electrode from the central terminal, causing almost 50% increase in the amplitude of the recordings. The augmented limb leads thus generated are called AVR, AVL and AVF. Augmented limb leads were described by Goldberger in 1942. Six electrodes are placed on specifically designated parts of the chest to get chest lead recordings. Chest electrodes are placed on the anterior chest wall as follows. V1, 4th right intercostal space, right sternal edge. V2, 4th left intercostal space, left sternal edge. V3, midway between V2 and V4. V4, 5th left intercostal space, mid clavicular line. V5, anterior axillary line, same horizontal level as V4. V6, mid-axillary line, same horizontal level as V4. Right chest leads are recorded from the corresponding positions on the right side. In right chest leads, V1 will become V2R and V2 will become V1R. So, one need to record only from V3R to V6R. But only V3R and V4R are usually recorded to detect right ventricular infarction. Whole set of right chest leads may be recorded in dextrocardia. Chest leads are often positioned at varying positions by different operators due to difficulty in ascertaining intercostal spaces accurately in obese patients and females. This may cause difficulty in comparing serial ECGs. Hence, every effort should be made to place the electrodes accurately. In some situations, when accurate comparison of serial ECGs is needed, marking the position with a skin marker pen may be needed. Chest leads are named C1, C2, C3, C4, etc. by some manufacturers. Here, C would stand for chest. In the conventional naming system, V stands for voltage. ECG monitoring leads are different from the usual leads used for recording a 12-lead ECG. This is because monitoring leads are used mainly for rhythm analysis and sometimes for ST segment monitoring to look for ongoing ischemia. Any lead which can show the P waves, QRS complexes and T waves well can be used for ECG monitoring. Often the monitoring lead will have to be tailored for each individual. It may be worthwhile to look at 12-lead ECG and decide on which lead is likely to give the maximum required information for that particular person. Most intensive care units monitor only one lead, while some resort to two lead monitoring for better arrhythmia analysis. All 12 leads are monitored during an electrophysiology study as well as during a treadmill exercise test. Several types of lead modifications are used depending on the situations. In the coronary care unit, modified lead 2 is usually used. Modification is that the limb electrodes are placed on the proximal parts of the limbs or adjacent torso rather than over the distal part of the extremity in order to reduce artifacts due to limb movements. Most modern monitors have the option to use chest leads in addition to limb leads. When chest lead monitoring is needed, additional electrodes are placed on the chest. Chest lead monitoring is useful in picking up ST segment changes. Location of the leads depending on the type of patient. While anterior locations are available in the coronary care patient, a surgical patient may require different locations depending on the location of surgical incision and dressings. Esophageal leads may be used in some rare situations to decipher difficult arrhythmias. Mason-Leica modification of 12-lead ECG is most popular during treadmill exercise test. It can also be used in the electrophysiology laboratory. In this lead system, limb electrodes are placed on the nearest location on the torso to prevent movement artifacts during exercise. Chest electrodes are placed in the conventional positions. Difference in pattern of the modified 12-lead ECG mandates caution while trying to interpret Q waves and other abnormalities on a Mason-Leica modification. Approximate positions of the limb and chest electrode in Mason-Leica modification. Lower limb electrodes may be placed a little lower than shown in the figure. The QRS axis has a rightward shift due to the upward shift of the lower limb electrodes, but there is no difficulty in interpreting ST segment shift and arrhythmias during a treadmill test with this lead system. Lewis lead is a modified lead to enhance the amplitude of P waves and thereby enable better arrhythmia analysis. This lead system is useful in detecting P waves during a wide QRS tachycardia and helps in differentiating between ventricular and supraventricular tachycardia. Lewis lead is a modified lead one in which the right arm electrode is placed in the second right intercostal space close to the sternum and a left arm lead is placed in the fourth right intercostal space close to the sternum, that is V1 position. A modified limb lead system for detection of atrial repolarization on surface ECG has been devised by Shivaraman and colleagues from India. It may be noted that atrial repolarization wave or TA wave is usually obscured by QRS complex in routine ECG. In this modified limb lead system, right arm electrode is placed in the third right intercostal space slightly to the left of the midclavicular line. Left arm electrode is placed in the fifth right intercostal space slightly to the right of the midclavicular line. Left leg electrode is placed in the fifth right intercostal space in the midclavicular line. Chest electrodes and right leg electrode are placed in standard position. If you like this video, please like and share it. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.